Hi, I'm Chris Reed here at the Hub Culture Pavilion at Sportmax in New York City with Rogelio Castillo from Secrets of the Modeling World. So Rogelio, can you tell me why you started Secrets of a Modeling World and a little bit about your background?
I used to be in event production when I was younger. Then I started doing some scouting for some agencies here in New York. I did some PR for another agency, kind of their supermodel division. Just a good friend of mine happened to become world supermodel now, Cecily Lopez, so she got me into this. Eventually, I traveled back to Mexico. I met some friends of mine that wanted to know about the real world modeling. Watching America's Next Top Model, trying to explain the big difference of what you see on TV and what really goes down. Came back to New York and just one day just started to decide to write a blog. Actually, we made the first logo on a PowerPoint thing. That was kind of, you know, it was not that good, but it was a start. I interviewed one of my friends. He told somebody else about what he just did, and we just started getting a little bit of a follow-up. Then we just kind of, it's kind of Cinderella story. We just kind of blew up and grew because we were giving models a voice and just talking about what really goes down within the agencies and the fashion industry, and not everything is glamour and private jets and parties. It's a lot of hard work. So that was why SMW was started.
What would you say the biggest single misconception is that people who, you know, look at the industry from the outside, look at all the PR, look at things like America's Next Top Model or America's Next Designer, things like that. What do you think the biggest single like misconception they have is?
The single misconception, models are not stupid. Like a lot of people, that really bothers me that they think because, they come here very, very young. They're just not booked educated sometimes, but you'll get to meet some of the most interesting individuals. Like they travel all over the world. They're just eager to learn about other cultures. If you go to our sites and you actually go in our archives, you can see this model like Runa that just did an internship for NASA. We have somebody else that is a biochemical engineer. And there's our girls that you see on the cover of Vogue or on the cover of Cosmo and a spreadsheet for a Balenciaga, and at the end of the day, they have a brain, and just people immediately think, she's a beautiful girl or a good-looking guy, they must have nothing up there. So that's kind of something that we're trying to, or I think we already got into that point, and people are not thinking like that anymore.
Where do you think this misconception comes from? I mean, it had to start somewhere. Do you think it goes all the way back to, like, Twiggy and the first supermodels, or do you think it's some born of something else?
Well, it comes from something. A lot of, models are very, very young when they come. Like some of these girls, guys start 14, 15. So like I said, they're not very well educated. They go out and they are exposed to this big world of like parties and just this very shallow world. So when they come to talk to a grown-up, let's say to an editor, which is, late 30s, well, he knows he's an educated person. So when they talk to him, they immediately think, that person, that model, that girl, or guy is stupid because they cannot keep up with the conversation. But what people don't realize is that they don't go down to their level. They don't talk to a 14, 15-year-old. So if you take that model, 15-year-old model, and put it with other 15-year-olds, they're way more cultured, way more smart because of their background and their life experience. So that's the misconception. They forget models are very, very young.
When you say new models coming to New York, what are some of the biggest traps and pitfalls that they come into?
Sometimes they get scouted by the wrong agency. That's always a bad thing. There's a lot of agencies that really, they're trying to rip off the models. They make money off of the models department, of developing their books, which is a lot of money. Sometimes it costs like $2,000 to $5,000 to develop a book. They really don't take care of the models. And then they enter, the fabulous world of nightlife, which is a big problem. So you see this 14, 15-year-old girls that just got here, they get mesmerized by this industry. And they just start going out. They lose track. That's when the other misconception that every model does drugs and stuff. Well, that's when they fall into it because they see other people doing it, so they immediately think they have to do it to be cool or to be accepted. Of course, there's the elite few that actually know better or become from better backgrounds, and they fight that. But that is a big problem. Like coming to New York as a young model, running into that lifestyle, like the parties and the drugs and the alcohol. Sometimes they don't know better. And that's where they're exposed to, and that's where they adapt, and that's what they do.
Great, thank you so much, Rogelio Castillo from Secrets of the Modeling World.